Haven't you always wanted to animate tables in PowerPoint? Here is the answer. Just select a table, go to our add-in, click on one button, Animate Table, and it's done. Now, I can show each cell one at a time. Isn't that brilliant? Just download this add-in and learn how to use it. The download link is given in the description. Download the files. One is a sample file, one is a PPAM file, which is the add-in. If you want to learn the code behind it, you have to use the PPTM file. After downloading, right-click on each file, go to Properties and unblock them. The next step is to install the add-in. Go to PowerPoint, File menu, Options. Under Add-ins, look at the drop-down, open it and go to PowerPoint Add-ins. Click on the Go button and in this dialog, choose Add New. And then select the PPAM file. Enable that checkbox and click Close. Accept all the security related things like enable macros, enable content, and make this a trusted file. And then in the add-ins menu, you will see all the options we have built for you. Today we are going to discuss Animate Table. To know what each button does, just look at the tooltip. Here is a table which shows what each button does. And we also have separate detailed videos. I have created all these over the years along with my friend Raj Chaudhary. Now let's see this in action. I have a simple table. I've selected it. And before I run this, I'm going to open selection pane. You go to Home, Edit, Select, Selection pane. Right now we have the title and the table. Now I'm going to click on Animate Table and see what happens. The original table is still there, but it is hidden. The original table had a name, table 8. Now that table had 3 rows and 3 columns. So each one of them is now a separate table. These individual cells are still table. So all the features of table are available here. The only constraint now is if you multi-select them, the table menu goes away. So whatever formatting you want to do, do it before you split the table. Now individual objects are available for you to manipulate. I'm going to open animation pane. And here you can see header plus 3 rows. So we have 12 items. And each one of them is going to run on click. And by default, we use appear animation. You can change that. So if I run it as it is, I'm not going to see anything in the table. First click is first cell, and then left to right, top to bottom, all of them are animated. In case you don't like it or something goes wrong, undo still works. If you undo, notice what happened? The original table has got unhidden, and all those individual cells are gone. Now let's take some other scenarios. So here is a standard table. If I run this, it's going to run like I showed you. Left to right, top to bottom. But let's see how to customize this. Here you can see 8 items. But I don't want them by row. So here you can see R1, C1, R1, C2 and so on. So you bring all the C1s together simply by dragging the animation. You're changing the order of animation. So now I have all the C1 together, but I just want one click for it. First one I want, second, third, fourth, I don't want. So select that and say start with previous. And do the same thing for column 2. Start with previous. And now on the first click, I'll get first column, second click, second column. And a more complex example is here. This is a table. There are 3 items, but I first want to focus on the numbers. This is the static table. This is the animated one. First click shows all numbers, and then further clicks show you what is the meaning of each number. One word of caution. If you select a table which has pictures, it's not going to work as expected. For example, if I try to animate this table, yes, the table does get animated, but if I move the cell, the picture is not associated with it. The solution is to animate the pictures manually. Bring them to front and customize animation. And one last thing. Look at the name of the table. Right now, this is a standard layout. So this thing is called content placeholder. Even if you put a table inside it, it is still called content placeholder. So now if you split and animate this table, so many items will get created with a very long name. So if you want to avoid that, go to selection pane, double click on the name and give it a simpler name. I'm just calling it character A. And now when you split it, the names got created, but they are much shorter and simpler to manage. I help customers globally to create high impact presentations. My email ID is in the description. Let's connect and grow together. Thank you for watching. Try this out and let me know your feedback. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe to learn and grow. That's all for now. See you next time.